the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi, Texas. A good crowd inside enjoying an action-packed card. Our main event coming your way. And entering the ring right now, Ramon Ayala is Jerry Belmonte. He's taking on a tough Puerto Rican and Abner Cotto, the cousin of Miguel Cotto. And somebody who knows about both fighters is standing with our own Jessica Rosales.
Thanks, Beto. I am with Omar Figueroa, who will be defending his title for the second time in just over a week at the StubHub Center. Omar, it is so loud in here, and I know you've made some changes in your training camp. How have you adjusted to those changes, and what kind of an Omar Figueroa will we see at the StubHub Center?
I mean, you can always expect the same Omar. I'm going to go out there aggressive and fight my fight and, you know, try to end it as quickly as possible. And, you know, when it comes to the training camp, everything went great. Honestly, it's one of the best decisions I've made, you know, when it comes to my career. And it's just a shame that, you know, I'm not able to work with Joel Diaz anymore because, you know, he was my second father while I was in California. So aside from that, you know, we tried to keep everything the same, more or less, and everything went great.
Jerry Belmonte, Abner Cotto in the ring. You have seen both of them. You've won against both of them. For the winner tonight, what does he have to do to be able to secure that victory?
I think they're just going to have to be, you know, aggressive because they're both boxers. So one of them has to be, you know, start the action somehow. So it just depends on who starts the action and who's more aggressive. And I think that's going to be the winner.
All right, Omar, thanks so much for the time. We're going to go ahead and send it back to Beto and Dave.
Omar Figueroa, the WBC champion. He's been in some good battles here in the state of Texas, also throughout his entire career.
We've seen him come up and win his championship, and he's now on hand to handicap these guys. We'll take a look at them. Belmonte is 1 year younger. The height advantage, just a little bit for Cotto, and Cotto will have a reach advantage. Let's see if he can take advantage of it.
And there you see Jerry, the Corpus Christi kid, Belmonte. He said 99% of the fans in this arena are his. I think it might be 100 if he takes on the Puerto Rican and Abner Cotto. Abner Bean Cotto, being the name given to him by his grandmother when he was born because he was so small, he just said he's a pin. And he's going to be taking on Belmonte. Let's go to our announcer, Joe Martinez.
And Fox Deportes from American Bank Center here in Corpus Christi, Texas. This is the main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing scheduled, this in the junior lightweight division. Presented by Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions in association with Leja Bata Promotions. Sponsored by Corona Extra, La Cerveza Más Fina, and O'Reilly Auto parts, better prices every day. Sanctioned by the Texas Department of License and Regulation, the commissioner in attendance, Greg Alvarez. The three judges appointed by the Texas State Commission, Ruben Carrion, Glenn Crocker, and Don Griffin. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, John Sharling. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the judges are ready and the fighters are ready. Corpus Christi, make some noise if you... Introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white trunks trimmed in red and black, he weighed an officially 130 pounds even. This 19-fight veteran brings an outstanding record that stands at 17 victories. Just two defeats, eight wins coming by way of knockout. Here is La Boricua de Aguas Buenas, Puerto Rico, Abner. And next, his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing navy blue trunks, trimmed in red and white. He too weighed in 130 pounds even. His professional record in 23 bouts, 19 victories, 4 defeats, 5 wins coming by way of knockout. He is the fighting pride of Corpus Christi, Texas, the Corpus Christi Kid, Jerry.
Okay, guys, give me a good clean fight. Obey my commands to protect yourselves at all times. Yo quiero una pelea limpia. Obedezcan, mis órdenes y protejanse a todo tiempo.
Two fighters don't like each other. Yesterday at the weigh-in, in each other's face. Some good pictures posted on our Twitter at Golden Boy Boxing, where he head-to-head, headbutt in front of each other. Belmontes said it got fired up. Cotto said it was boring. Might as well do something, but there is some good animosity between these two.
Yeah, he fired up the weigh-in, all right. And, you know, you figured that that energy should carry over into a noisy place like this.
Abner Cotto from Aguas Buenas, Puerto Rico, translates to the good water. See if that water gives him an advantage here tonight in Corpus Christi as he takes on the hometown kid, Jerry Belmontes. Belmontes wearing blue with white and red trim. Pincoto, white with red trim. Both these fighters coming out quick.
So Belmontes talking about the anger issue and he's mad and everything like that. Now, he's got to harness that. You want a little bit more get up and go, but at the heart of it all, he is still a boxer. And he can't get too much into a slugging mode and think that he's going to try to knock down walls. He's not that type of a fighter.
Last time we saw Jerry Belmontes, he was fighting for the WBC title at the StubHub Center in Carson, California. That was in April. He lost a split decision to Omar Figueroa, a fighter he knows very well from their amateur days. Figueroa from the Weslaco area in the Rio Grande Valley. And Figueroa, Justin Rosales interviewed him. Both of these guys. So a lot of familiarity in this building.
And it's interesting to see what type of a fight a guy takes right after he loses a title bout. And how long does he take? Now, he bounced back quickly from that to take this level of fight. And you have to make sure you're emotionally charged up and that you're ready to make that big move, because some guys can suck a little bit after a tough loss.
On the fight, I worked with Doug Fisher from Ring TV, and we looked at that fight and we thought, you know, the way that Belmontes fought early on, he really controlled it, but the last four rounds went away from his game plan and he lost the split decision. 1-3 in his last four fights is Jerry Belmontes, but you look at the fighters he went up against. He lost to the Chango Cancio. Francisco Vargas is a great fighter now, and he came back in Las Vegas on the undercard of the Angulo Canelo fight, and he beat easily Will Thomas, an undefeated fighter from Australia. So that got him back into the mix. And now he's headlining in his hometown. Good jab from Cotto. He's wearing the white with the red trim. Cotto's last fight, he lost to Francisco Vargas. The decision. There he has him in the corner. Anytime that Belmontes has an advantage, this crowd is going to go wild for him. It's been loud in here. And here he goes, and the body goes upstairs. Cotto's trying to wrap up.
He did catch him, though.
Ten seconds to go in the first round, scheduled for 10. As Cotto's backing up here. Wild swing and a miss from Belmontes. That'll do it for the first round. Good one for the hometown kid. This broadcast of Golden Boy on Fox is brought to you by Corona Extra, La Cerveza Más Fina, and O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day.
Belmontes found himself at the end of the round, the right hand on the run, then the left hook to the body, and even as he's getting held, he goes to work, pushes down. Makes the most of the situation here, and the uppercut gets in. With Cotto turning his back, he almost landed a big hook. Cotto can't turn his back. That's a mistake.
Rejuvenated Jerry Belmontes. Coming out quick to start the second round. Junior lightweight, scheduled for 10. Ethel Duran along with Dave Bontempo and Jessica Rosales, our main event. Crowd is really fired up in the ABC Center in Corpus Christi, Texas. And we have some breaking news about an upcoming fight. Jessica, what do you have?
Yeah, this was just announced. The fans, you're hearing it here first. Golden Boy Live returns to Texas on September 29th. All the action will go down at the State Farm Arena in Hidalgo. Antonio Tarver will make his return to Fox Sports 1 facing Jonathan Banks in the night's main event. Tickets for this go on sale next week.
Ooh, that should be a good one. Keep coming back. Golden Boy Live card. It just seems like every time you're on a Golden Boy Live card, you have a good show.
Well, Tarver and Banks, guys with a lot of pedigree, have made a lot of noise. Tarver, a champion throughout many years, and Banks upsetting Seth Mitchell last year, and training championship fighters. So that's an interesting showcase to see where these guys are.
There's some names out there getting back on TV. We're in the second round between Belmontes and Fim Cotto. Cotto's corner telling him in Spanish earlier between rounds, throw your jab, throw your jab. And between rounds, Belmonte's corner told him double jab.
The jab is the big weapon for both of these guys. They happen to be mirror images stylistically, so it's a matter of who wants to gamble, who wants to double up, who wants to take the chance to get inside, to follow his jab, and then get down in.
The Jerry crowd gets going. We expected that. We expect a lot more of that. As good right hand landed by Belmontes. Less than a minute to go in the second round.
And because of that, and the idea that it is his crowd, the pressure will be on Belmontes to be the one to change the flow of the fight and turn it into a more aggressive spectacle.
And coming up on September 11th from Las Vegas, 9/11, Hard Rock Hotel, Luis Ortiz and Latif Coyote. And the Hard Rock has been a place where Golden Boy Live has been going, and you begin some good fights. Ortiz and Coyote will be a good one on FS1. Belmontes in the blue trunks. Against Cotto, the white with the red. Puerto Rican coming into the backyard. They didn't care. Just wanted to fight. Gets tagged by a right hand. 10 seconds to go in the second round. We're scheduled for 10. Corpus Christi Kid and Fim Cotto mixing it up in Corpus.
From across Canada, on the winds of change, stories are being gathered.
We're back in Corpus Christi, Texas, the ABC Center. Jerry Belmontes, Abner Cotto, the cousin of Miguel Cotto. Cotto 17-2 with 8 knockouts in his career. Lost to Omar Figueroa and Francisco Vargas. Both these fighters coming off losses. Both these fighters said they need to put on a show. Both of them said their backs against the wall if they want to maintain an ability to be a draw, to be a name in this division.
So they need the fight, and the tiebreaker in that reference might be Belmontes and the fact that he comes off a world title fight. One of the judges gave him the nod, so it was a split decision. So his expectations rose, and he was mad at himself for some of the things he could have done in that fight. So now he hopes to bring that work ethic to all of his fights.
Belmonte telling us that he's now more motivated and hungrier because he's been so close.
I think he surprised himself a little bit at how close he got. And one of the judges gave him the nod, and he lost to the two other ones. So you get an idea to measure. Okay, look, this is a world championship fight. This is how close I was. Now I can get that remaining distance.
And what does he want after this? A rematch with Omar Figueroa. Where? Anywhere. It doesn't matter. Wherever, he said. He just wants a chance with that rematch with the WBC champ.
Well, he'd have to give Figueroa and the people who make the fights a compelling reason to do that. So that's his mission.
Belmont is getting tagged by a good right hand from Cotto.
Cotto nailed him with the jab, too.
Belmont has been kind of bouncing off those ropes.
He started the round trying to use the head movement to get inside the jab and take the chance. But the head movement didn't bring him any closer to the target. It was all on the outside. He needed to do a little bob and weaving to get inside the jab. He bobbed the weave from too far out.
Good jab landed by Cotto. Good right hand from Cotto.
But Belmontes dodged the bullet. He landed the two jabs, and as he tried to slide out, he was hit with a grazing right hand.
Looks like they might have butted heads. Referee John Shorty jumped in there immediately. 10 seconds to go in the third round. A low blow. Cotto gets hit, puts his hands up right away. Belmontes, he's shaking his hand, he's back to the corner. Cotto got hit, a late reaction, but he's still given the time by the referee, John Shorty. He's right there in the corner with him. And we're going to continue. That'll do it for three rounds. Tonight, don't miss Fox Sports Live as Jay and Dan, those two, oh my goodness, bring you all the news and highlights from a full day of MLB and NFL preseason games. Fox Sports Live is after the fight on Fox Sports 1 and streaming live on Fox Sports Go. Those two do a great job.
All right, theatrics at the end of the round. The headbutt came first. Cotto darting away in pain, and then that hurt more than a headbutt. A low blow to the sensitive area as Belmontes was leaning back. As he was leaning back, he let his hand go, and that's why it strayed low.
All right, Jessica Rosales, who's in the corner of Jerry Belmontes, tells us that there's a slight cut over the left eye of Belmontes, something we have to look for. Go to the fourth round. Belmontes in the blue, going on the white with red. Now Belmontes complaining that Cotto went downstairs a little bit.
Well, the referee is in a laissez-faire mode. He's been letting the guys settle it themselves and not take control. This is what he's got to do.
As you were saying, laissez-faire, it's get in the mix, John Shorty. I was starting to see some of that animosity from yesterday's weigh-in.
Well, you know, from the referee's standpoint, if you don't jump in there, then you're just extending what these guys are going to try to do on their own. They need to have the interpretations laid out for them.
The limitations. Now Cotto warned about hitting behind the head. A little mix from Cotto. Belmontes continues to stay on those ropes.
And Cotto doing an effective job on the outside jabbing.
And he gets hit down low. Way down low goes Cotto. Belmontes falls.
Now second time. Can give you up to 5 minutes if he deems it appropriate. And these guys have been hustling back in. Now we have a point, and this will be very frustrating for Cotto, who was hit low himself in the last round and not even a warning.
But it was the second time that Cotto has hit Belmontes below the belt. A point taken away. Corner is very fired up for Cotto as Belmontes comes with the body. Belmontes keeping those hands down low. A little bolo action from Belmontes. And he gets tagged with the left and the right. A big right from Cotto. Less than a minute to go. Another right hand from Cotto. As Cotto gets a point deducted this round, landing the bigger shot with less than a minute to go. Another right uppercut.
He's come at Belmontes after the point deduction and the flagrant shoulder roll there he gets away with. Interesting thing is, you want to come on strong. The judges almost always go 10-8 in this situation, though.
And now you see referee John Shorty really getting involved. Anytime they clinch, he's in there. Good combo from Cotto. Abner Cotto gets tagged with the right, loses a point for a low blow, but he lands some of the bigger shots here in the round. And referee John Shirley warning him. Good combo from Cotto. 10 seconds to go in the round. Left hand block. That do it for the round. So interesting to see how that one gets scored, considering a point was taken away by referee John Shirley for a low blow by Abner Cotto.
De nosotros, ¿ok? Es de nosotros.
All right, it's been low blows here tonight. That one was low by Belmont is on the belt line, not called, still low, and then it was a forced action, and then this is where the point is taken too. So Cotto has to feel like he doesn't have a friend in the world in Corpus Christi. He gets hit low, nothing happens. He throws a low shot and loses a point.
Yeah, he knew he wasn't gonna have any friends. Finding a hostile environment, no biggie. 2007 went to Brazil in the Pan Am Games, won silver against the Brazilian, beat him. I have no problem going to somebody's backyard. I can win.
What you like to see is going to happen here now. Will Cotto be gun-shy about those borderline shots, which are also part of his body attack? If you are afraid of having points taken away, basically, the area a little above the trunks gets taken out of play.
Well, two fighters have just been going upstairs above the trunks. Doesn't seem like to be a game plan for either of these guys. A little bit of a mouse underneath the right eye of Jerry Belmontes here in the fifth round, scheduled for 10.
But regardless of where they are going, you're a fighter, you hope that you have the whole target to shoot at. And now it basically dwindles for a while. Good hook by Cotto. He brought his attitude here.
Cotto saying he wanted to fight Belmontes because he knew he could beat him. He was confident. Instead of taking a lesser tuna fight at home, then no, give it to me. And he's landing upstairs. Belmontes saying no, but he's getting tagged. Cotto definitely bringing the action here in the fifth round. Now Belmontes trying to use that shoulder.
And Belmontes is on the inside, not really where he drew up his game plan. He wanted to jab and go in and out, not necessarily camp on the inside.
Belmontes saying that he wanted more combos to work more angles. Well, there's not much he's working right now when these two are just on top of each other. Good right hand for Belmontes, countered by Cotto. Cotto the good mix. Cotto the body shot. Left uppercut.
Guys are both working nicely, though. Good punching zone for both.
Thirty seconds to go in the fifth round, scheduled for 10. Body shot from Belmontes. Covers up as Cotto tries to go downstairs. Good right hand from Cotto. 10 seconds to go in the fifth round. Corpus Christi Kid against Bing Cotto in Corpus Christi, Texas.
Hey, don't forget, we're coming up in Antonio, Texas, September 29th. Antonio Tarver will step into the ring against Jonathan Mason.
And next weekend in Carson, California, the StubHub Center, Sean Porter, the world champ, takes on Kell Brook. Also, Omar Figueroa from Weslaco, Texas, takes on Estrada. And Bika against Durrell, a rematch. That's a fight that Bika really took it from Durrell in the super middleweight division, WBC. Sean Porter, Carson, California, should be a good one. A lot of action in the last round, especially in the center of the ring, Dave.
That's where they just abandoned all their boxing philosophies and tried to slug, go at each other in that last round. It was good, in tight action. Cotto seemed to be more comfortable in there at that place in the ring than Belmontes was.
Both fighters very confident in their abilities, and they both look very confident in this fight. Been a tough one. The big difference is that Cotto was deducted a point for a low blow in the fourth round. Jerry Belmontes said that Cotto was slow, had no footwork. Cotto showed a little bit different.
Well, he's trying to play on the concept of Cotto being slow and no footwork in the first minute of this round. He's effective. Jab, the hook outside. He's moving himself. He's out hustling Cotto, and this has been best sustained action on the outside for him in quite some time. He's getting the jab in, and he's timing Cotto coming in, so he's able to land a hook and then dart off to his left.
Jerry Belmontes says he's more motivated now, but a couple of years ago, he was really frustrated with the way his career was going. He was winning, but he wasn't really training. He'd go to the gym, but really wouldn't put in the work. He lost to Eric Hunter. After that, he didn't even know if he wanted to continue to be a pro fighter. And then he got back into the mix. Now he's 100% completely dedicated because he can taste that he's almost there. But he's in the top one right now with Abner Cotto here in Corpus Christi in the sixth round.
And he's going to really have to do this with intellect and boxing, being smart, doing what's working for him on the outside. The battle on the inside in the last round, not necessarily what he wants to do. Stay outside here, try to make Cotto come to him at this point.
Well, Cotto was knocked out by Omar Figueroa. Why? Because he came in overconfident. Then he walked in there thinking he was going to take care of Figueroa. He found out the hard way. And after that, he realized you have to really respect your opponent. Also, when you're a Puerto Rican and you have the last name of Cotto, there's some big expectations from you.
And you have to give an exciting fight every time out. And he is giving a very good effort here. He has forced Belmontes
to change his corner. Belmontes walks away. Cotto just looks into his corner. But okay, give me some directions here. What am I doing? Odd.
No, Belmontes is outside and confusing him in this round. This has been tactically one of the best rounds Belmontes has put together. Now they're going to see what they can do to adjust.
Closing seconds of the sixth round. A good one between Abner Pincotto and Jerry the Corpus Christi Kid Belmontes. Tony throw the jab, get inside. Push him back. Again, push him back. This is trainer Juan de Leon in the corner of Abner Cotto.
You know, it's there. Everything that you're
Belmontes had a good round on the outside. punctuated by that right hand. He was doing what he wanted much of the round. Cotto, when he got him trapped, was able to land a good, strong right hand. And at the end of the final moments of that round, he's looking into his corner for direction. What do I do? Well, they told him.
Look into the corner for directions when your fighter, your opponent, is a couple feet away. Okay.
Well, protect yourself at all times, but it is an emotional game, and you can have a mental lapse now and then, which he did.
Seventh round, Bethel Duran along with Dave Von Temple and Jessica Rosales as the slate goes flying in the corner. Belmonte's in the blue, Cotto in the white. Been a tough fight for both of these fighters.
But now if you're Belmonte's after that big last round on the outside, you view yourself as a championship fighter. You have to start putting rounds like that together. That is your objective, to try to string them. And if you're Cotto, you're taking that momentum away by getting inside and going to work, just as the corner yelled at him several times in that last round to do.
Belmonte's comfortable on the ropes. As the referee trying to separate him, and he tags Belmonte with one. He's ready. Been deducted a point that Cotto has for a low blow.
Well, he got a half point discount there because that could have been a point.
With the referee right there on you,
right
hands
there,
on
and
you,
and you're disobeying it and landing a shot.
Cotto, the more active fighter in this round. Going downstairs, upstairs.
Now they're both willing on the inside, and that's unusual for Belmonte's after that big round he had on the outside to choose to be here.
Just stand in the middle. It was an exchange. Cotto with the reach advantage. He's taller. He's leaning on top of Jordan Belmonte. Minute to go in the seventh round. Scheduled for 10.
This is where Cotto wants this fight to be right now.
It just wears on you also, doesn't it?
Yeah, he's a strong guy. He's wearing on Belmonte's, but also after that last round, this is a gift for him not to have to have Belmonte's on the outside jabbing and hooking him as Belmonte's did.
30 seconds to go in the seventh round. Jerry Belmonte, Abner Cotto in Corpus Christi, Texas. Two fighters just been all over each other from the opening bell. Can't get any kind of space between them. Yeah, it's exactly what the weigh-in looked like yesterday. Two heads on top of each other. Why get a big range? Just give him a little shoebox. Get in there. The phone booth. As he goes down, but he's been pushed down, and there he trips Cotto. It's Belmonte. He fired up. Cotto said no. And he's showing him. Belmonte's coming over and saying, no, you tripped me.
Half anger, half sportsmanship, then they called it a push. End of the round action. Tying up, feet get tangled. Down goes Cotto. Down goes Belmonte. All of it incidental contact. And it gets ruled that way.
UFC on Fox, August 16th, Saturday. UFC Fight Night returns to Fox Sports 1 with a full card of epic bouts, including a light heavyweight matchup between 8th-ranked Ryan Bader and 10th-ranked St. Pro. It all begins with the pre-fight show at 7 Eastern on Fox Sports 2. They catch the main event at 10 Eastern on Fox Sports 1.
We talked about Cotto having lost a point. This is living dangerously. That's where he could have gotten a point taken away just for not obeying the referee.
Cotto runs out at the bell of the 8th round. So they tripped each other in the end of the 7th. Cotto comes out really aggressive, snaps back the head of Belmonte. Belmonte's now being aggressive. Forget standing on top of each other. Let's just swing it now.
And for him, swing it, but on the outside. Move the feet. Fire the hook outside. That's how he starts the round, at least.
And again, Belmonte gets tagged after the referees trying to separate him and living dangerously as Cotto. Already been deducted a point for a low blow.
And now he's had two that he's been able to skate on. Cotto tries to trap Belmontes as Belmontes moves straight back. And because he moves straight back, he walks into that.
That tag by a good right hand by Cotto. And coming again, combination from Pin Cotto.
Now you can't belabor that point about for Belmontes, the movement side to side is key, because when he stopped just there late in the fight, he was drilled. That was Cotto territory.
Cotto landed the heavier punches in this fight. Jerry Belmonte 19-4 with 5 KOs. Cotto 17-2 with 8 KOs. Good jab from Cotto. Corner yelling at him, saying he's yours, go get him. He's very loud.
Cotto everywhere. He is trying to walk him down now, and Belmontes is standing there, allowing him to come. So credit Cotto for doing that to Belmontes.
Cotto looking very fresh, less than a minute ago in the eighth round, scheduled for 10. Belmonte, a little mouth underneath his right eye, a little cut over the left eye. Cotto continues just to walk. There he gets hit by a right.
And when he got hit by the right, he had to reset. That was a good move by Belmontes. Shuffle, score, and then Cotto was caught in between and had to reload.
Second time in his career that Cotto is fighting in Texas. The last time when he lost to Omar Figueroa when he was knocked out. There he's looking good against the hometown kid, Jerry Belmontes, with 10 seconds to go in the eighth round. Amir Cotto forgetting about the crowd. He's forgetting about anything. He's actually quieted down this crowd with the manner he's fighting against Belmontes. Separated again. And another punch after the referee steps in the middle by Cotto. Belmontes saying something to him.
So his corner was more animated than Cotto's. They were trying to get the idea to him to double jab and then go into his power shots. Cotto doing nice work on the inside here, and this is where Cotto would like to conduct business, and he shows you why.
Jerry Belmontes is in the top one in his corner with Jessica Rosales. What do you have, Jess?
Yeah, in Belmontes' corner, every time that they saw Cotto land punches, they were yelling at him, work, Jerry, work. To win this fight, they feel that Jerry needs to get busier, work behind his jab, and set up his left hook.
Well, we've been talking about has to start with the jab. That's a natural edge for him. And the key is that he's got to be doing it from the outside, because on the inside, Cotto's been able to get the edge on him.
And Belmontes putting his hands down, like, okay, hit me. And then, like, your punches aren't hurting me, but still, you're getting hit.
No need to do that. That's a absence of focus for him. And Cotto has been stout. He's standing up, and he's really made it a difficult fight for Belmontes and forced Belmontes out of the comfort zone of the outside. And then sometimes Belmontes takes himself out of the outside.
Cotto looking very fresh here in the ninth round, scheduled for 10. And if you look at Belmonte, if you get a shot at the eye, it's starting to close on the left eye. That was cut early on in the fight, and it's starting to swell up really nicely, the left eye. And he's also had a little bit of mouse underneath the right eye. So Belmonte is showing the wear on the face. Wondering how, if that's affecting him.
He tries to bob and weave and get close here, but it was too late in getting that last punch off.
Abner Cotto usually is fighting at the 135 weight class. Last one against Vargas, he came down to 130. And tonight, both of these fighters are at 130. So he does what most boxers don't do. He drops weight, and he's looking good. Abner Cotto in the white, Belmonte is in blue, and Cotto is just really in control, real smooth about his wave right now with 10 seconds to go in the ninth round.
He's pushing Belmonte's off the mark.
Crowd very quiet. This was a raucous crowd during the introductions. Not so much after nine. Saturday, MLB on Fox Sports 1 returns with a doubleheader. Derek Jeter and the Yankees will be in the Bronx, taking on the Indians in a game you can only see here on Fox Sports 1. Then Matt Holliday of the New York Cardinals take on the AL East leading Orioles. Coverage begins Saturday at 12:30 Eastern, only on Fox Sports 1 and streaming live on Fox Sports Go.
Slip. Use your head movement. Move your head and try counter after head movement. Make a miss with the jab. Come back to play.
Well, this was not in the Belmonte's blueprint. Standing in the middle and trying to avoid the shots as Cotto tees off, and Cotto scores in nice fashion here. And that's a strong collection of shots, which should lead him to take that last round. And then as Belmonte drops his hands.
And there you see Abner Cotto. Here's 10th and final round from American announcer Joe Martinez, puts up his hands and looks into the crowd. Nobody's on your side, Cotto, but he doesn't care. He's feeling good about himself right now as we go to the 10th and final round between Jerry Belmonte and Abner Cotto in Corpus Christi, Texas. The Corpus Christi kid not looking that strong against Cotto. It's frustrating at times.
Yeah, Cotto has been able to really out-muscle Belmonte, push him back, bother him, take him out of the comfort zone. Under the idea that Belmonte was going to stay outside and jam. He has done that and shown that at times, but in other times, he's been muscled.
Interesting to see how that point taken away will be a factor in the scorecard. Belmonte was hit below the belt by Cotto in the fourth round. A point was taken away.
And then you would suspect that that often leads to a 10-8 round. Maybe that's even a 2 or 3 point swing in that round. And since that point, ironically, it's been a better Cotto.
Yeah. I was in the fourth round, and Cotto staying calm, and there he is with a nice little flurry, leaning on top of Belmonte. Admiral Cotto's trainer said, "We came to win. We know we could win." Juan de Leon, really happy with the way the training camp went for Abner Cotto. Belmonte is also very confident. This has been a good fight, good tough fight for both fighters.
He's had a guy on the inside in his face pushing him back and forcing him to try and move. He's done that effectively at times, and then when he doesn't stand still, Cotto lands his best shots.
Abner Cotto, let his hands go a bit here. Good right hand. Jerry Belmonte staying right there. Uppercut missing. Cotto lands a right. Less than a minute to go in the 10th round. The crowd is getting up. Jerry. Abner Cotto continuing to work. Uppercut, right hand. Pin Cotto looking fresh here in the 10th and final round. Both fighters said it was make or break for their careers tonight.
Well, Belmonte took a tough fight coming off Figueroa. And he's in a real battle now against a guy who's been stronger than he is.
Cotto said he didn't want a tune-up fight. He wanted Belmontes because he knew he could beat him. He's come to the hometown of Belmontes and put on a good show. 10 seconds to go in the fight. Belmontes, Cotto. And that'll do it. Abner Cotto raises his hands, thinking he's victorious. Jerry Belmontes goes to the corner of Abner Cotto, shakes their hands. And there you see, getting picked up. Abner Cotto by his trainer will come back with a decision at Corpus Christi.
An important free.
Thanks, guys, and we're back in Corpus Christi, Texas. A good fight between Abner Cotto and Jerry Belmontes, a tough one for both of these.
Yeah, the styles, this ended up being an inside fight, which is what Cotto wanted as his fight went along. Belmontes said 99% of the people here for him. It started out like a rock concert, and for them at the end, maybe they were in a library as it got quiet for them. Turn around, a low blow, that was a big moment against Cotto. He lost a point for that, but he came back. And from rounds 5 through 10, he was a different fighter, strong on the inside. In the 6th round, Belmontes showed how he should be doing this fight all along. He stayed outside, but then inexplicably, he went inside. And when he went inside, he was in Cotto's territory. And Cotto battered him, moved him back, out-muscled him, and the way he beat him up, the question is, when did the judges give him the love? We'll find out.
Well, we will find out moments away. Let's go to the ring announcer, Joe Martinez.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Here are the totals. Judge Ruben Carrion scores it 95-94, Cotto. Judge Glenn Crocker, 95-94, Belmontes. And Judge Don Griffin has it 96-93. Your winner by split decision, Abner Cotto.
Well deserved, a great effort on the road for Cotto.
Abner Cotto goes into the backyard of Jerry Belmontes, gets the decision, a split decision, 95-94, 96-93. He improves to 18-2 in his career. The 26-year-old cousin of Miguel Cotto looked good tonight. He gets the win.
He certainly did. A good surge for him at the end of the last 3 rounds were his.
A decision that he said will put him back into the mix. Abner Cotto gets the win from our studios in Los Angeles. For Dave Bontempo, Jessica Rosales, I'm Beto Duran. Fox Sports Live rolls on.